Mr. Ollivander. I wondered if you might be able to help me with something.
Good to see you, my young Ravenclaw friend. Allow me once again to express my family's gratitude. They were pleased to learn that the wand Richard Jackdaw disappeared with those many years ago had been located, even if it was somewhat unusable.
Glad to hear it.
Now, I received an owl from Eleazar, Professor Fig. He was a bit cryptic, said you need to have a special wand crafted, that you'd bring me the materials.
Yes, sir. I have them here.
Oh, my. How extraordinary. Remarkable design. I will be honest, I have never crafted a wand in this fashion. Repaired broken wands, of course, but this is something else entirely. Keeping me on my toes, aren't you? I think I can work with what you've brought me. Let me see what I can do. It is done. I should warn you, I've never seen a wand like this before. My suspicion, as Professor Fig implied in his letter, is that it serves a unique purpose. I doubt you shall find much use for it otherwise.
Thank you, sir.
I'm afraid you're on your own. I've ensured that we have a moment to ourselves. Oh, come, come. No need for such theatrics. In light of what Ranrok now knows, you must agree that our interests are aligned.
Our interests will never be aligned.
You would let goblins take what is rightfully ours? The final repository belongs to wizard kind. We would be fools not to work together. What's that you've got there? Might this sudden visit to the Wand Maker have something to do with our mutual pursuit?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
That repository is my birthright!
Charles Rookwood wouldn't have wanted you near it!
The arrogance. Should have known better than to try and reason with a child. I've always said, children should be seen and not heard.
Try.
over. I'll need to send an owl to Natty right away. For now, though, I need to get back to the map chamber and tell Fig what's happened. Revelio. Victor Rookwood is dead. He confronted me as I left Ollivander's with the Keeper's wand. I had to defend myself.
Godric's heart, are you all right? I know you're well able to defend yourself. I've seen it often enough. But Rookwood himself...
He destroyed so many lives and wouldn't have stopped. I'm glad I was able to put an end to him.
You're right. He wouldn't have stopped. You did what you had to do. The wizarding community owes you a great debt.
Thank you for saying so, Professor. I'm ready for what's next.
All right, then. The Keepers have been waiting.
You have completed all of our trials, and you have done so under circumstances even I did not foresee. You understand now why all of this was necessary. The portkey, the vault, the locket, the book, the trials, to ensure that one with the ability you and I share would make the same choice that San, Neve, Charles, and I did.
Now that you have witnessed my memory, you understand all that is at stake. Not everyone is what they seem.
As you know, light does not exist without shadow, nor shadow without light. Simply because you can eliminate darkness does not always mean that you should.
Even the most well-meaning and competent amongst us cannot possibly know the consequences of manipulating what should be beyond our reach.
What lies in the repository must never be released. Resist the temptation to destroy or control it. The magic that you have so carefully honed must now be used only to protect the secret we keep. You have the wand. You will know when to wield it. We leave our legacy in your hands.
Astonishing!
hope that the enchantments protecting the castle would protect against an incursion from below.
I fear they may not. Although, if they don't now, I can assure you they will in the future.
Were you able to reach Professor Weasley?
I was. Hopefully she and the others will arrive soon. They know where to find the door through which we entered.
is what Miriam, George, your friend Lodgok, and countless others died for. Miriam believed this forgotten magic could be used for such good. But she did not know the risks. She did not see what the Keepers have shown you. What Isadora showed you. You are now the Keeper of whatever power it holds. What do you intend to do with it?
I have decided to open the repository. Its power cannot lie dormant for centuries more.
After everything you've seen, what about Isadora's fate?
Isadora wasted her ability trying to save people from themselves. I will not let others dictate what I do with this. My power.
You cannot possibly mean that. You, of all wizardkind, are wholly aware of the misery and pain that that could cause.
The arrogance of wizardkind. Goblins built this repository. It belongs to us.
Enough, Ranrok. It was never yours.
I've been wanting to play with this.
Miriam's wand.
If she'd simply handed over the katana, all of this could have been avoided. Foolish.
Thank you. I dare say he was a beloved professor to many of you, certainly a long-standing colleague to his peers. A famed adventurer and seeker of knowledge, he built a reputation charging into the unknown, brazenly disregarding both discretion and safety, providing perhaps a rather unfortunate lesson for us all. His devotion to adventure was rivaled only by his dedication to Hogwarts. And of course, to his wife, Miriam, whom we lost much too soon as well.
Possessed a brilliantly inquisitive mind, and was the most loyal of friends. But perhaps it was his remarkable courage, for which we will all be forever indebted to him. If not for Professor Fig, that if not for him, many of us, let alone Hogwarts, would not be here today. Those that knew him best will agree that we must now honor him as only Hogwarts can, by wisely, resourcefully, justly, and bravely facing all that lies ahead.
To Professor Fig!
Can't believe we lost Fig. I didn't know him as well as you did, but I know he was a good man. Glad Weasley spoke for him. She honored him well. Fig will be well remembered. I realize the same should be done for my uncle. I hope Anne agrees to see me.
Sebastian, I can't imagine what you and Anne are going through. Perhaps you'll hear from her soon.
I hope so. I'll let you know.
Sebastian, there's something you should know. It's to do with Victor Rookwood.
I heard a rumor that he confronted you outside of Ollivander's. Sounds as if he faced quite a fight.
The rumors are true, and I did. But it's not that. Just before Rookwood attacked, he uttered something familiar. The same words Anne heard before she was cursed. Children should be seen and not heard.
Wait. What are you saying?
It wasn't one of Ranrock's loyalists who cursed Anne. It was Rookwood. It was Rookwood all along.
This can't be. It was the loyalists. It's always been them. The night Anne was cursed, all she saw were goblins.
Once Rookwood allied with Ranrock, Isidora's estate became of interest to them both. That's why Rookwood was there the night Anne was cursed. He was working with Ranrock. When he saw your sister, well, he didn't want anyone to know.
So he cursed her, and she's never been the same. So cruel. Rookwood deserved what he got. Thank you for telling me. It wasn't a goblin. I suppose I owe you an apology. All this time I thought goblins were the enemy. But it was never that simple. As for what happened in the catacomb, I've not stopped thinking about it. Perhaps we could meet soon. There's much I wish to say.
always said that travel broadens the mind.
Places around the school for Zenobia's gobstones. Professor Weasley, you wanted to see me?
I did. We haven't had a chance to speak since I know you were quite close with Professor Fig.
Hogwarts won't be the same without him.
No, it won't. But I can assure you that he would want us to press on, and that he would rest easy knowing that the future of the Wizarding World is in hands like yours.
Thank you, Professor.
You've had quite a year, both inside and outside of Hogwarts. I've heard all sorts of rumors. You've ridden a Rapphorn, befriended a goblin, rescued hippogriffs, even helped Mr. Ollivander track down a family wand.
How did you...
It's harder to keep secrets around here than one might suspect. I'm just glad you found such a good friend in Mr. Sallow. I believe it's been a difficult year for him. He was lucky to have you.
Thank you, Professor.
No need to discuss it further. What I would like to discuss is your wizard's field guide. May I see it?
Of course. What do you think, Professor?
I think you've been busy this year. I see some progress here. But quite a bit of your field guide has yet to be completed. Fortunately, you do have some time to prepare for your OWLs. I will confess, I had a sense about you from that first moment you came bursting in, late, to the sorting ceremony. I am pleased to see that my instincts were correct. To think you've only been with us a year and you'll already be taking your OWLs, well, it's nothing short of astonishing.
Thank you, Professor. For everything.
You are most welcome. I look forward to seeing what you do during the rest of your time with us.
Nice to see you, my young friend.
she's devastated. She just buried your uncle alone.
I did it for her.
Sebastian, Anne can't bear the thought of turning you in, but...
What? Turn me in? She saw what happened.
I'll give you some time to think, Sebastian.
Turn me in?
Sebastian.
Did you hear that? You saw what happened. I never wanted to hurt my uncle.
I know.
I can't believe he's gone. How did things go so wrong? I didn't mean it. I didn't mean to... Oh, Anne, I was only trying to help. I can't leave now. Anne needs me more than ever. You understand. You can talk to Ominous. Make him understand. He listens to you. I need to be with Anne.
Don't worry, Sebastian. I shall speak with Ominous.
Thank you. You're a good friend, truly.
No matter what happens from here, I'm glad we met.
Poor Sebastian.
Ominous.
What a mess. I can't believe it. After I last saw you, I went straight to Hogwarts. Before I had time to talk to Black, I heard from Anne. I rushed to Feldcroft and found her with Solomon's body. She was beside herself with grief. Part of her wants Sebastian to face the consequences, another part can't bear the thought of it. I don't want to lose Sebastian, but I don't think we have a choice.
We do have a choice. What good will it do to turn him in now? He clearly regrets everything. He's not going to do anything like this again.
We've both heard that before.
But we also need to think about Anne. She's lost her health, now she's lost her uncle. Do you really want to take her brother away from her too?
I understand what you're saying. Perhaps you're right. As much as I believe that Sebastian should pay for his actions, we'd only be punishing Anne as well. I hope we're doing the right thing. I'll talk to Anne. If it comes from me, she'll agree with this decision.
Thank you, Ominous. You're a good friend.
Whatever lies ahead, we must face it together. That I know.
Revelio.
About what you told me.
And you say they made it after you placed the moonstone.
Do you know why or what it means? Does it have to do with the Snidgets?
The breadth of one's knowledge can be as wide as the seas. Only run so deep.
It's good to see you again, Doran. Did Poppy tell you about everything that's happened?
She did. And I am glad to see that you are both safely returned. I did question the wisdom of sending you on a path at a time when that path was unknown at best, deadly at worst. But the acumen of the centaurs is neither personal nor partial. The skies tell us what is to come, and often we do not know what we have seen until it has come to pass.
You knew the poachers would try to kill Poppy and me.
I did not know, my young friend. But I shall say that I was not surprised. It was in much the same manner that I expected our first meeting.
I don't suppose you'd like to start from the beginning. I think Poppy and I could use that.
Of course. I find it is often the best place to start, is it not? Many, many moons ago, I divined a series of events. Their meaning long evaded me, until you brought news of the Snidgets and their poacher pursuers. I believe the symbol created by the Mooncalf's dance marks the place the Snidgets are hidden. And serendipitously, I believe that I know the very place.
Please, go on.
I have seen that symbol only once, on a rock face in the cliffs of the forest. You should make haste there. The Snidgets that have been kept there for so many years may no longer be safe.
If you're right about this place, then we should make our way there.
I shall see you there. We cannot afford to lose the Snidgets once again.
Handy resource indeed, your field guide. I'm most pleased to be included.
I'd be grateful if you could help me and my friend with a time-sensitive delivery.
Unicorn blood will keep you alive.
Wonder who lives here. What do we have here? A demigod. Alohomora.
Thank you.
train tunnel.
Off on another adventure, are we?
Be strong, Alexandra.
Is everything all right?
If the Hamlet sent you here to talk to me about... I know what I have to do. It's not every day a girl has to put down her own troll. I should be allowed to work up to it.
What do you mean, your own troll?
I thought that's why you were here. I'm sorry. I suppose if you spend enough time with trolls, you forget your manners. I'm Alexandra. I didn't mean to be short with you. With Ranrock's lot seemingly everywhere, I thought the Hamlet could use a bit more security. But my plan has gone awry. I apologized when he almost trampled half the Hamlet yesterday. He just needs more time. But everyone wants him gone. They think it's mad, my training a troll. Impossible, even.
It certainly takes a lot of courage to try. I'll give you that.
Thank you. Thank you for saying that. I wish others felt the same. But I suppose I understand why everyone's been so concerned. What made me think I could train him? I should have learned from Barnabas the Barmy. But he's my troll and my problem. I'll be honest. I'm afraid I won't be able to take care of him. He's stronger than any troll I've ever encountered. I wish I knew someone else who could do it.
I'm not thrilled at the prospect, but I'll consider it.
Oh, no. I didn't mean to suggest that you should do it. In fact, you should avoid the area just southwest of here. At least until I work up the courage to do what needs to be done.
Revelio. A troll on the loose near a hamlet. That could be devastating.
I can always rely on my patrol.
Not sure how I'd fare in a little place like this.
Hello. Might you have time to help with an urgent delivery?
You sound as if you could use some help.
Oh, yes, I could. Eddie Thistlewood's the name. A dear friend of mine in Feldcroft is at his wit's end due to the relentless attacks on his hamlet by Ranrock and his loyalists. I sent 2 crates of Chinese chomping cabbages to help, but they've gone missing.
Good idea. Those cabbages are nothing to be trifled with.
My thoughts, precisely. You see, I know plants, and I believe the goblins will be so irritated by the onslaught of ferocious vegetation, they'll simply leave Feldcroft alone. I wonder if you might track the 2 crates down and deliver their contents to my friend, Bernard Ndiaye. I simply can't leave my shop at present.
Very well, sir. I shall keep an eye out for 2 crates of Chinese chomping cabbages.
Oh, thank you. I shall let Bernard know he might be receiving those cabbages after all.
What do you have for sale?
I'm convinced that Feldcroft will be much safer with Chinese chomping cabbages defending them.
Sounds like Feldcroft's in trouble. Perhaps I should try to help.
I'll be able to put that to good use. Thank you. I hope to see you again soon.
It's like a place right out of a storybook.
I have to admit.
Revelio.
The
Revelio.
Bombarda!
I got here as soon as I could.
Did you see the symbol above the entrance? It's the one the Mooncalfs made at the Henge. Of course Doran implied as much, but to see it up there...
Could this actually be where the Snidgets are hidden?
Let's find out. Doran's waiting for us just up ahead.
I'm ready if you are.
Can you believe it? Actual Snidgets! I'm glad we seem to be a step ahead of the poachers.
It is a little strange we haven't heard anything from them.
If we're lucky, they're still poring over Gran's research. There was a fair amount.
Revelio.
We, on the other hand, had Doran to guide us. Even if the poachers do somehow stumble upon this place, we shall be long gone.
Greetings.
I hope we haven't kept you waiting long, Doran.
Not at all. Then again, it is not I who awaits your arrival. Do you have the Moonstone with you?
We do.
Good. It is as important to what happens next as both of you are.
So, what does happen next? What are these pillars here?
A safeguard, I suspect. There is only one way to find out. And as for how to go about that, the two of you may know better than anyone.
Lumos.
Lumos!
Snidgets are here. The herd will want to see the truth of it for themselves. Elik especially. Go on without me.
I haven't seen my grand study.
Look at the murals on the wall. They're all creatures. This place must have been built to protect them. They had nothing to fear.
Confront them! What makes you say that?
The poacher camps always felt oppressive. It's hard to explain, but the feeling was palpable. At least to me. The sense I get here is of safety and calm, quite the opposite of the poacher camps.
Hmm.
Let me...
symbols on them.
Revelio.
Thank you.
Revelio.
I had hoped to return before it was too late.
We're fine, but you hadn't got here when you did. I led them here, Doran.
You fought with us against your kind. I am glad to have witnessed this. I now believe what Doran told me.
They are the ones I saw.
Finish your work. All the events you divined have not yet come to pass.
Revelio!
You both fought bravely today. Allow us to carry the mantle from here.
If it's all right, Doran, I think I'd like to stay behind and spend a little more time with the Snidgets.
Revelio. Confringo. Bombarda. I take it you're Alexandra's friend. Revelio. Confringo. Alexandra, the Hamlet needed to be saved from that troll. Revelio. It's done, Alexandra. I took care of him. My troll? What? Oh, I don't know what to say. Thank you. I wish things could have turned out differently for him.
There wasn't much you could have done. He was beyond training. Tried to kill me the entire time.
Goodness. I'm glad you're all right. You're very brave. People in the Hamlet had already crafted a moniker for whoever eventually defeated my... I mean, that troll. It was troll something or other.
Slayer?
Yes, that was it. I suppose it's your title now. I need some time on my own. But truly, thank you for what you did.
A nice ring to it.
Did you deliver the Chinese chomping cabbages to my friend Bernard yet?
Mr. Thistlewood, what was it you needed my help with? Crates of cabbages?
I wonder if you might track the two crates.
Very well, sir. I shall keep an eye.
Oh, thank you.
What do you have for sale?
Now, how can I help? Thank you.
Thank you. I hope to see you again soon.
Levioso and Stupefy combined should put any brute in their place.
I should investigate. Revelio. Revelio. Today's Revelio. Yeah.
Revelio. This could prove dangerous if I'm not careful. These rocks have seen better days. Confringo!
that. Settled.
Talking beast, it's the Necro that's the real commodity, surely you agree?
It's exhausting.
I'll figure out why there's such a fuss over poaching. Enough dumb beasts for everyone.
Thank you.
it works in Gringotts. Couldn't pay me.
Revelio.
Looks like the statue Madame Twiddle mentioned.